Dear students, welcome to NRS YouTube channel. So in the previous class, we discussed regarding MS Access 2010. So in the MS Access 2010, so we discussed one object called, that is table. So first of all, you need to open the MS Access 2010. So here, as you already know that how to create the database and all, right? So just I will open the already created database. So that is NIRS database we have created in the last class. So just I will open it. Yes, so in the NIRS table, sorry, database, in NIRS database. So in the last class we already created a table called student details. So students, you can see here in the navigation pane, here we have already created the table called, that is student details, right? Student details table we have already created. So just I will maximize that one, right? So here we have a student details. So next thing is how to create the data types and how to use creating the fields in the table called student details, right? So students, just you can right click on the student details table which you have already created. So just right click on student details. Here you have an option called design view. So click on design view. Yes, so here you have a field name and then data type, right? So the key which it has the symbol of key, the symbol key represents that a primary key, right? So already in the theoretical class, in the theory class, already we discussed what is the primary key and foreign key. So I will remove this primary key now. So just right click on the symbol key symbol and then click on primary key. Yes, so our primary key has been removed from the field name. So here the field name and data types. So the field name is nothing but the column name, right? The field name is nothing but your particular column. So now the what is the column? So based on the your requirement, you can go for the field name. So I will go for the first is the rule number. Rule number I will enter is the first field. And the rule number, the field name is rule number. Next we have the data type, right? So data types, we have different data types. We have a integer data type, number data type, text data type, memo data type, right? Default value data type. And next we have different type of data types we have. So for the rule number, which data type will be suitable, right? So just click over here. So okay, then click on okay. Well, so here data type, so I will go for, so remove the dot from the rule number and then go for, yes. So click on a drop down list. So in the drop down list you can view the different data types like text, memo, number, date and time, currency, auto number, OLE objects, right? Hyperlink, right? So for the rule number field, which data type will be applicable, right? So it must be number, right? So I will go for number. Okay, so then go for the next field. So the next field name should be student name. Student name, right? Student name of the student. So this is a field name. Next go for the data type. So the student name should be, right, text data type, right? So I will go for text. And next I will go for the another field in my table, that is I will go for phone number, right? Phone number. Okay, and the data type should be, it is also a number. Okay, data type should be number. And then I will go for class. class field name, and it should be the you can go for text or you can go for number also. I will just select the number as well. Okay, yes. So these are the different type of fields I have, that is roll number, student name, phone and class, and their data types, right? Respective data type. One is roll number is having number data type, student name is text data type, and phone number is having the number data type, class is having also the number data type. So now you have to save this student details table. So how to save? Just you can double click over the student details. So here, yes, so just double click on the table, you will get a dialog box. You will get a save dialog box for the particular field. Just I will minimize this one and then I will go for, yes, field name, design view, yes, save this file. Yes, it is saved now. So now you can just, whenever you open the student details table, what you will get? You will get the roll number, student name should be, yes, student name, phone number and class. So the roll number you can enter one, and student name, it is an ABC, and then phone number you can enter, right? Right, one. Right, and class you can enter 10th class, right, and then press enter button and then go to the next row. So what I have entered, so the roll number is 1, student name is ABC, phone number and class is 10. So this is complete roll number 1 record. So this row we call it as 1 record, right? So again you can enter, go for the another data, right? Yes, so this is how you can enter the data information manually into the table. Okay, manual into the table. So here in the next class we will see, so another data type like a default value and auto number, and how the auto number will be work and how the default value data type will be work, right? So along with that we will see what are the advantages of the data types, some data types we have, so what are the advantages of those data types in the table. Okay, so that we'll see in the next class. Thank you.